up by the heavy duty and the all new Colorado. So with these three trucks, kind of the cool thing about them is, you know, they share a lot of the same truck DNA, whether it be the high strength steel, the fully boxed frames, the locking differentials, making all these trucks very capable. They also share some great innovations, including the corner step bumper and 4G LTE Wi-Fi. And with that, the market's responded. Sales of these trucks are up 32% for us. It's kind of a great new story. And from our perspective, we really think this is because we've listened to our customers. We're, you know, delivering what the market wants, which is a truck that fits people's lifestyle. And we think we're doing that with these three trucks. So let's start with Colorado. Colorado has been just a huge success from a launch perspective. Best truck launch that we've had yet. We're pretty much selling every single Colorado that we can build. And one interesting stat for you would be, when you look at our monthly sales, that number, we actually sell more Colorados in a month than we had in inventory at the beginning of the month. And what that means is Colorado is the fastest turning truck in the segment, which is kind of a great stat. So we're working really hard to figure out how to build more of these trucks to meet demand. And even though the truck's only been out a year, it doesn't stop there. We just released the Midnight Colorado and the Trail Boss, which, well, it was parked over here before they drove it off. And both of those special editions feature a lot of accessories. And what we found with the midsize segment is these customers want to personalize their trucks. So about 40% of the Colorado sold are actually delivered with accessories already installed. And then for 2015, Colorado won Motor Trend's Truck of the Year Award. I know this surprised a lot of folks when nine judges unanimously voted it the winner. I don't think it was that much of a surprise to us. We talked a lot to our midsize customers. We've been out there doing a lot of research on the truck, spent a lot of time with them, and this is what they told us. They really want a stylish and refined pickup truck, but they want it in a size that sort of fits their life and preferably something that actually fits in their garages. But they also want class-leading fuel economy, because this is a truck that they're driving every day, but they still need capability. They need to be able to tow because they're going to use this to pull their toys around. And they want the ability to take the truck off-road. You know, a fully capable truck, these customers genuinely live very active lifestyles. But possibly more important than what they told us they wanted was what they also did not want, which was to give up the refinement and the features that they've experienced in the car, in the cars and crossovers that they've moved to over the last decade as they transitioned out of the midsize segment and now are ready to come back in. So the other thing that these customers have been asking for is a diesel. So we've got a new 2.8 liter Duramax diesel. This is a next generation diesel for us. It actually is a powertrain that's used globally. It's proven, it's got a lot of miles on it, a lot of tested, and this will actually be our cleanest diesel that we've built yet. And even though EP estimates are not final yet, you're gonna get a chance on the fuel economy loop to kind of reset your fuel economy to zero, and I encourage you to play with it. And I think the number yesterday that's the best one of the week that you, your target to beat is like 42 miles per gallon, which is pretty impressive. So that's your challenge. Now, what would a Duramax diesel be without capability? And the 2.8 liter Duramax delivers class leading towing at 7,700 pounds, fully capable truck. And you're going to get a chance to drive, and you know, the vehicle loaded. They've got a couple configurations of trailers out there for you to tow. So you get a chance to drive it loaded, unload, and you're also going to get a chance to take it to the off-road course. And one of the trucks on the off-road course is going to be that Trail Boss that they took away from me. Which basically, the Trail Boss is a pretty cool truck. You know, it's built on our Z71 platform. We had DuraTrack tires for enhanced off-road capability and some really cool off-road type accessories that are both functional and stylish. So let's move over to the other end of the spectrum, our heavy-duty truck. This is another area where we take kind of a customer-focused approach to developing this vehicle. Sales of the HD are up 17% this year. Off to a great start, and I would argue in that segment of heavy duty is probably the one of the most competitive parts of the truck market. And you hear a lot of our customers out there talking about all these great big claims about what you can tow, some really kind of crazy numbers. We've kind of stayed away from that. We take a little different approach to heavy duty. For us, it's all about confidence and safety and making the person comfortable, you know, towing that large load. And we do it with things like powertrain grade braking, diesel exhaust braking, the integrated cruise control, the integrated trailer brakes, all of these systems work together to take the stress out of, you know, long distance towing. And that's where our focus has been. And for the 16 model year, we're adding digital steering assist that you're going to get a chance to experience today on two heavy duty high country diesels that are out there. And new digital steering assist basically improves steering feel. It's going to help you on a crowned road, and it's also going to help you when you're pulling a big trailer and, like, you know, wind or any place that, you know, you're kind of working the steering wheel to take the stress out of it. And of course, what would our HD be without our legendary Duramax Allison combination? With over 1.5 million engines sold, this is a tried and true powertrain that's proven itself. Which, I guess no surprise, our military has selected the Duramax diesel to power the next generation of joint light tactical vehicles that will basically replace the Humvee in the future. So there's kind of a military grade joke there somewhere that I'm gonna pass on. So Silverado sales. I already mentioned that, you know, Silverado's off to a great start. The 1501 was named the highest ranked light duty pickup in initial quality by J.D. Power, and sales of it are up 17%. And again, we think this is because we've listened to our customer and we focus on what's important to them. Which, for example, when you look at our V8 engine, V8 engines are still the choice of a light duty buyer. And this is where we spend a lot of our time and energy delivering the best V8 engine we can. The Gen 5 version of our legendary small block V8 basically delivers best-in-class fuel economy, horsepower, torque. You know, it's the right combination, and we have several out there for you to drive today. So, but it doesn't stop there. You know, we launched the truck in 2014, and just 2 years in, we're kind of refreshing the front end because we knew our competition had a lot of new trucks coming. And just to keep the vehicle fresh, we pretty much have updated the entire front end. Brian did a great job last night of walking you through the design of, you know, what we did, how we did it, why we did it. And for us, it's all about the new face of strong. It basically builds upon, you know, the our kind of our positioning of the most dependable long-size pickup truck on the road. Bold new front end, but it also includes a lot of customer-focused technologies. So you guys saw a lot of the lights last night, or at least I think most of you did. Here's a nice shot of an LTZ Z71. And basically every one of our Silverados will have LED daytime running lights for that signature lighting going down the road that you're not going to be able to mistake a Silverado for anything else that's on the road. And our LTZ and High Country models feature LED projector lamps, and then they also add the turn signals, and running lamps. So, and it's not just about, as I said, lighting and good looks. We've added a lot of technology to the vehicle. 8-speed transmission on our LTZ in High Country with a 5.3, remote power locking tailgate, wireless phone charging, forward collision alert, and lane keep assist, which is an upgrade from our lane change alert, and telebeam headlamps, and our segment exclusive power articulating step that we have on two of the trucks back there that I would encourage you to play with. And then another feature that actually turns out to be pretty cool, as I got a chance to play with it quite a bit yesterday for the first time, is the Apple CarPlay. This is a feature that once you're in the car, I would encourage you to plug your phone in and get the demo from Ara today. We will have Android Auto coming later in the year, but it's just kind of a great feature. We already know that our truck customers are one of the biggest users of OnStar and 4G LTE in the vehicles. So being able to plug your phone in and have in those, you know, apps that are most important to you at your fingertips is kind of a really nice feature that we think our customers are going to appreciate. So with that, you know, Chevy trucks are on a roll. I mean, you know, we're delivering the trucks that our customers want and the sizes that they want, powertrains. It's something that we're going to continue to do going forward, and we're, you know, pretty thrilled with the success we've had so far. But with that, I also got to talk a little bit about crossovers. Crossovers, we're doing great, and also sales are up 31%. The Trax has jumped into the number two spot in the small SUV segment, and it brings a lot of new customers to Chevrolet. A younger customer, a more female customer, and this is another product that our dealers cannot get enough of. And then you've got the Traverse. Sales are up 17% this year. It continues to conquest a lot of customers because it still is the most family-friendly vehicle due to its, you know, flexible interior and seating configuration. And then, of course, there's the Equinox. This is a vehicle that competes in the compact SUV segment, which for the first time last year outsold the midsize, becoming the largest segment in the auto industry. And Equinox sales are up 15%, and again, it continues to conquest. The Equinox is really in a kind of a position of strength within that small SUV segment. Since it debuted in 2009, it's increased sales every single year. There's more than a million of them down the road in North America. It's been a top safety pick 6 years running, and it tied for highest ranked compact SUV in initial quality by J.D. Power. And for 2016, we revealed the new Equinox with a refreshed front end at the Chicago Auto Show. So it gets new front end, fascia, some new lighting, some wheels, and some very important safety equipment that we know are important to these customers. And we have a couple of those out there for you to see and drive.